Geneva Motor Show 2017, Preview. The 2017 Geneva Motor Show is almost upon us. Find out everything you need to know about the new cars that we'll see there, right here. The biggest motor show in the calendar is drawing nearer, and you've come to the right place for full, in-depth coverage of the 2017 Geneva International Motor Show. With the Geneva show all set to kick off in the second week of March, manufacturers are already teasing us with details and images of the new models that are going to grace their stands. We also have a very good idea of what else to expect in the show halls, although going by past years, a few surprises are also on the cards. The Geneva Motor Show is one of the European motor industry's most important events, and it's always a hotbed of activity for new car launches and big news scoops. The show has been running since 1905 and currently takes place every year at the Geneva's PALE Expo Exposition Center, with this year's edition the 87th overall kicking off on March 7, 2017 with the first of two press days. The Geneva show opens to the public on March 9 and tickets are on sale now. As always, we're going to be treated to an incredible collection of new production cars and concept cars. Highlights will include the reveal of the new Renault Alpine A120, seats all-new Evisa Super Mini, the Range Rover Velar SUV and the facelift of the ever-popular Nissan Qashqai. Add in the usual bumper collection of Geneva Motor Show supercars and models fettled by the various tuning houses and you have a recipe that will have any self-respecting car fan salivating. As always, the Auto Express team will be out in force at Geneva 2017, bringing you the best pictures, interviews, breaking news stories and video reports on all of the key show cars. Live. Geneva 2017, the key cars. The major new car launch is coming at this year's Geneva Motor Show. Alpine sports car / A120, Renault sports car sub-brand to be reborn with homage to legendary Alpine A110. Vauxhall Insignia Grand Sport, Vauxhall to go push further upmarket with plush four-door coupe. Volkswagen Arteon, new VW saloon to replace Passat CC will take on BMW 4 Series Grand Coupe. Seat Evisa, new Seat Super Mini to get fresh looks ahead of all-new Arona crossover. Mitsubishi Eclipse Cross, all-new crossover will inject some style into Mitsubishi's range and take on the Qashqai. Nissan Qashqai facelift, Britain's best-selling crossover to get minor styling tweaks but big tech upgrades. Range Rover Velar, Geneva reveal likely for new Range Rover bridging the gap between Evoque and Range Rover Sport. Ferrari 812 Superfast, Ferrari's replacement for the F12 has a 6.5-liter V12 and 789 bhp. Geneva 2017, press conference timeline. Keep up to date with all of the new car reveals with our handy interactive press conference timeline. Geneva Motor Show 2017, the cars in detail. R2Z run-through of the cars we know will be on show at Geneva 2017. Alpine. Renault has been brewing a rebirth of the Alpine brand for some time now, and it's expected that this year's Geneva show will see either a reveal of the marque's new sports car rumored to be called A120. Alpine recently revealed that its Porsche Cayman rival will make use of a lightweight aluminium construction, will be mid-engined and will have a price tag around £50,000. Aston Martin. After it arguably stole the 2016 Geneva show with the all-new Aston Martin DB11, the brand is keeping interest in its elegant supercar on the boil with its new bespoke Q personalization program. The DB11 at the show will be finished in Zafir blue paint, with carbon fiber details on the splitter, sills, diffuser, and door mirrors. Audi. Audi has confirmed its new super hatch will put in an appearance at the show, the RS3 Sportback. The new car boasts a reworked 2.5-liter 5-cylinder turbo engine packing 395 bhp and 480 Nm of torque, and with a 7-speed dual-clutch gearbox plus quattro all-wheel drive it's capable of 0 to 62 miles per hour in 4.1 seconds and a top speed of 174 miles per hour with the 155 miles per hour electronic limiter removed. Audi may also treat us to a look at the production version of the Q8, possibly in SQ8 guise. BMW. BMW's headline act at Geneva this year will be its new 5 Series Touring Estate. The most practical 5ER yet is 36 millimeters longer than the previous generation, and will take on a raft of recent estate talent like the Volvo V90 and the Mercedes E-Class Estate. There is also new i8 Special Edition, 2, Protonic Frozen Black. Citroën. Much like the Vauxhall Maeva morphing into the Crossland X and the Peugeot 3008 getting a more rugged look, this C-Air Cross concept shows how the next generation Citroën C3 Picasso will be morphing into an SUV. Design cues from the new Citroën C3 are everywhere, including the slim LED headlights and air bump inspired door sills. Dacia. Dacia's cheap and cheerful estate gets the rugged treatment in the form of a new Stepway version. The new Dacia Logan MCV Stepway, to give it its full title, is essentially a cut-price Skoda Octavia Scout and is a way for Dacia to cash in on buyers' appetite for more rugged models. Some new Summit Special Editions will also brighten up Dacia's Geneva stand. Dendrobium. A new all-electric hypercar concept from Singaporean electric vehicle makers Vanda Electric is poised to appear at the show. So far the company has revealed that its hypercar has been developed jointly with Williams Advanced Engineering, the technology wing of the Williams Formula One team, while the murky teaser shots provided hint at the car's low, angular, and aerodynamic bodywork. DS. The DS brand will set out its mid-sized SUV stall in Geneva with the DS7 Crossback. It'll be a rival for the Audi Q5 when it arrives on sale later this year and will serve as the DS brand's flagship model. Eden Green. One of the most mysterious cars heading into the show is the Eden Green Black Quillen. Only one teaser shot has been revealed, this dark sketch plotting the car's outline, but it's clear that the new British sports car maker is prepping a retro-futuristic Morgan rival. We'll get more details closer to the show. Ferrari. Ferrari will debut a new flagship Grand Tourer this year, boasting the most powerful naturally aspirated V12 engine it has ever fitted in a series production car. Called the 812 Superfast, its 6.5-liter V12 engine produces 789 bhp for 0 to 62 miles per hour in 2.9 seconds and a top speed over 211 miles per hour. We'll have more details plus exclusive pictures of its aggressive bodywork when the show kicks off next month. Ford. Although we've already seen it and it's been fully unveiled, the all-new Ford Fiesta will inevitably make its first public debut at the 2017 Geneva show. It's arguably one of the year's most important cars, and comes in a range of new guises including an active crossover model and a luxurious vinyl model. Plus, Ford has also teased a new Fiesta ST model, so that should be at Geneva, too. Honda. Headline act for Honda this year will be the official reveal of the next generation Civic Type R, building on the merits of the current model by sticking with a 2.0-liter VTEC turbocharged engine. Based on the 10th generation Civic, it should continue to be an aggressive-looking thing if the Civic Type R concept revealed last year at the Paris Motor Show is anything to go by. Hyundai. Hyundai's new load lugger, the i30 Tourer, will make its public debut at PAL Expo. The capacious estate will rival the Vauxhall Astra Sports Tourer and the Ford Focus estate when it goes on sale later this year. In fact, the new i30 Tourer trumps the Astra estate for load space. Eitel Design. Eitel Design will unveil this new V10-powered supercar filled with gills, vents and angles. Since Eitel Design is part of VW Group, it uses the same engine found in the Audi R8 and Lamborghini Huracan, and is capable of topping out at 205 miles per hour. Jaguar. As far as we're aware, Jaguar won't have anything show-stopping at Geneva this year. However, it will be unveiling the facelift and revised F-Pace, XE and XF models for the 2018 model year. All three of these cars have improved engine ranges and more tech on board. Con. Following on from last year's reveal of the Aston Martin DB9-based WB12 Vengeance Coupe, Caen will return to the Geneva show with a convertible version, the Vengeance Volante. Expect the original 510 bhp 6.0-liter V12 engine to remain in place, with a price tag exceeding £300,000. Kia. The next generation Kia Picanto is coming to Geneva before going on sale in the UK this spring, and Kia has already revealed pictures of its new city car in racy GT line trim. The new Picanto gets a 15mm longer wheelbase for a little extra space in the new cabin, but it's no longer than the outgoing car. Engines should be shared with the latest Hyundai i10, meaning a 6.5 bhp 1.0-liter 3-cylinder, and an 8.5 bhp 1.25-liter 4-pot. Lamborghini. One of the likely supercar reveals at this year's show will be over on the Lamborghini stand, with the unveiling of a new hardcore variant of the Huracan. Rumored to be called the Huracan Performante, spy shots of the car reveal an aggressive aero pack including a huge new rear wing and additional power building on the car's 6.02 bhp 5.2-liter V10 could be on the cards too. Land Rover. As revealed by Auto Express last June, Land Rover has identified a gap between the Evoque and Range Rover Sport and will fill it with this, the Velar. This teaser is all we have to go on at the moment, but it is understood that this new coupe SUV will take on cars like the BMW X6. Lexus. We've already seen the Lexus LS at Detroit, but the new wafty luxury car will take pride of place on the brand's Geneva stand in hybrid form. The new LS500h is capable of reaching 87 miles per hour on battery power alone and uses the multi-stage hybrid system first seen on the Lexus LC Coupe. McLaren. McLaren has introduced a new car at Geneva for the last 4 years, and will continue its streak this year with a new Super Series model to replace the 650s. Rumored to be called 720s, the Woking-based company has revealed a little information ahead of the car's reveal, such as its new all-carbon monocage 2 chassis and active rear wing, but most details remain under wraps. It should arrive with more power, and our spy shots suggest McLaren has plenty to hide in the design stakes. Mercedes. Mercedes's Geneva debut list is longer than almost every other brand going. The biggest debut there will be the new Mercedes E-Class Cabriolet, which has recently been teased, and we can expect to see the new E63 4MATIC estate. However, what will arguably garner more attention is the absolutely bombastic new Mercedes-Maybach G650 Landaulet. It boasts a convertible roof for the rear seat passengers, who also get S-Class style reclining seats, a glass partition, plus a 10-inch infotainment display each. Limited to 99 units, the Landaulet won't be coming to the UK. A series of AMG special editions will be unveiled at the Geneva show, too. Mitsubishi. It wouldn't be a motor show without a new crossover, and Mitsubishi will step up to the plate at Geneva 2017 with a new family car to take the fight to the Nissan Qashqai. The new Eclipse Cross will sit above the ASX in Mitsubishi's range, and the teaser image confirms it'll take design inspiration from the XR5 concept. We've driven a prototype, and you can read our impressions here. Nissan. Nissan says it has exciting crossover news planned for Geneva 2017, and we've been expecting a Qashqai facelift for around a year now, following on from last year's Qashqai premium concept reveal. The Qashqai facelift should take on some of the premium concept's minor cosmetic alterations, but big new tech will be the car's showpiece, with semi-autonomous driving modes rumored to feature. Pagani. One of the standout hypercar debuts scheduled this year will be on the Pagani stand, as the Italian manufacturer unveils the Huayra Roadster, a drop-top version of the Huayra. 7.53 bhp and over 1,000 nm of torque is promised, but it'll be limited to 100 units, all of which have already been sold. Peugeot. The shooting brake lives. This Peugeot Instinct concept car is long, sleek, and hooks up to Samsung's Arctic Cloud, a service that supports the Internet of Things, IoT, Connectivity for everything from smartphones to fridges, fitness monitors and home thermostats. It's powered by a 297 bhp plug-in system and is fully autonomous. Pininfarina. F1 legend Emerson Fittipaldi has joined forces with Pininfarina and WA to create the EF7 Vision Gran Turismo by Pininfarina, a new supercar making its debut at the show with a 592 bhp V8. It'll be recreated digitally to feature in the Gran Turismo series of games. Another vehicle on the Pininfarina stand will be the hybrid Kinetic H600, a premium saloon concept designed and built by Pininfarina on behalf of Hong Kong-based Hybrid Kinetic Group. Little is known, other than its name alongside image we have here, but it's a luxury sedan concept and new energy propulsion is promised. Porsche. The current 991 generation 911 GT3 made its debut at the Geneva show in 2013, and this year Auto Express understands that a facelift model to be offered with a 6-speed manual gearbox and a new engine is likely to appear. Engine capacity should rise to 4.0 liters, with power above the 500 bhp of the 911R. Skoda. Skoda is planning on taking Geneva 2017 by storm with a swathe of new models. Along with the hottest Octavia ever in the form of the Octavia VRS 245, there's also the facelift Citigo and Rapid models to spot, too. Plus, if you want your Kodiaq SUV either more rugged or more sprightly, Skoda is showing off its new Scout and Sport T-Line trim levels for your pleasure. Seat intends to make a splash at this year's show with the introduction of an all-new 5th-generation Avisa Supermini, ushering a new look closely following the angular new facelift Leon in design. Seat busied itself in 2016 with the launch of its first SUV, the Ateca, and the new Avisa will form the basis of a smaller SUV, known as the Arona, later in the year. SsangYong. SsangYong will uncover a concept car previewing a new midsize SUV, which will rival the Kia Sorento and Hyundai Santa Fe when it goes into production. Called the Zavel Concept, the shady teaser images hint at a car using an evolution of the firm's design language, while a 7-seat cabin has been touted. Subaru. A year on from appearing in concept form, the new Subaru 15 is set to make its debut. Our teaser image suggests the final design will stay very close to the Geneva 2016 concept, and hybrid power could be on the table along with conventional boxer petrol and diesel engines. It'll go on sale later in 2017. Suzuki. A next-generation Suzuki Swift is on the way and primed for a full reveal this March, though we've already seen what the new Suzuki Supermini looks like. It gets a sporty, angular new design setting it apart from the rounder, more sensible Baleno. It's a larger car than the outgoing model but lighter thanks to its new chassis, and it should be on sale this summer before a new Swift Sport in 2018. Tech Rules. Tech Rules introduced the AT96 hypercar concept at the Geneva show last year, though this year the firm promises to go one better with a production-ready display of its turbine recharging electric vehicle, TREV. The car is previewed in our teaser image, and should the figures be comparable to last year's concept, a powertrain developing in excess of 1,000 bhp could be on the cards. Toyota. Toyota has confirmed that the next Yaris will get a hot hatch variant to mark the company's return to the World Rally Championship, and will get a full reveal of the new Ford Fiesta ST rival at Geneva. Details are still scant, but we've got official pictures showing off the new Yaris wearing a lively body kit, and Toyota promises that it'll develop more than 210 bhp. The iTrill is another concept car heading for Geneva. Toyota has confirmed that the iTrill is an electric vehicle, and the teaser image suggests a tall and thin shape, so think along the lines of the Toyota iRoad from a few years back. Vauxhall. Vauxhall intends to push the Insignia further upmarket in 2017 with the introduction of the new Insignia Grand Sport, a classier, more high-tech on its saloon with the BMW 3 Series in its sights. Inspired by 2013's Monza concept, the Grand Sport ushers in a four-door coupe look, mated to a longer wheelbase. A plush new cabin loaded with tech and a revised engine lineup signal Vauxhall's new aspirational ambition. The estate sports tourer model will also be at the show. Volkswagen. The Insignia Grand Sport won't be the only new aspirational four-door coupe at the show, though VW will debut the Arteon, a replacement for the Passat CC and new rival for the BMW 4 Series Grand Coupe. The totally new model will be a step up in quality compared to the CC it replaces, with a sleek new design, new technology, and a starting price of around £30,000 when it goes on sale this autumn. We've driven an early prototype, and you can read our impressions so far here. Volvo. Volvo's reinvention is in full swing, and the brand's next car to go under the knife is the midsize XC60 SUV. We've only seen teasers so far, but from Volvo's current design trend and the image above, we can safely assume it will look like a Mini XC90 and could see stuff like the brand's PowerPulse engine tech trickle into the range. Geneva Motor Show, location, 2017 dates, and ticket prices. Planning a trip to Geneva Motor Show this year? Below is some of the key information you'll need to get a ticket, and get there at the right time. Dates. The Geneva Motor Show opens with two press days, and this year they're on Tuesday, March 7th and Wednesday, March 8th, although there are a number of press preview events, where key cars will be revealed, on the evening of Monday, March 6th. After that, the show doors open to the public from Thursday, March 9th, and it's every car fan for him or herself. The final day of the 2017 Geneva Motor Show is Sunday, March 19th. Opening hours. On weekdays, days when the Geneva show is open to the public, the show halls are open from 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. On weekend public days, it's 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. Location. The giant Pale Expo Exhibition Center is the home of the Geneva Motor Show. The address is Route François Peyrat 30, 1218 Le Grand Sacan X, but Pale Expo is right next to Geneva Airport, so it couldn't really be easier to find. The proximity to the airport means there are good train and bus links from elsewhere in Geneva, and although the Pale Expo car parks are reserved for exhibitors, driving is an option. Parking facilities are provided near the venue with an estimated 5,000 spaces during the week and 10,000 spaces on weekends to be found within a 5 km radius of the venue. Just be prepared for some heavy traffic. Tickets. Geneva Motor Show 2017 tickets are available from the official website. The cost isn't unreasonable given how much there is to see, with adults charged 16 Swiss francs, about £13. Pensioners, disabled people, and children between 6 and 16 will only have to pay 9 Swiss francs, around £7, and there's a 50% discount on any tickets bought after 4 p.m. on the day of entry.